Almost a month since their last meeting, the Esk Valley community on the East Coast is coming together again to see if police and politicians have listened to their demands. This time, opposition parties have been invited to share what they would do to protect communities from crime, particularly in the aftermath of Cyclone Gabrielle. To tell us more, we're joined by community leader Louise Parsons. Kia ora, Louise. Last time we spoke, it was a pretty fearful community. How are you all feeling about the situation now?
Oh, good morning. It was fearful because obviously it was sort of 2 weeks after the disaster and there was a lot of crime going on, a lot of looting. The last meeting that we had, actually the opposition were there as well, but no one had a platform to speak at that meeting. Everyone was there just to listen, and that's exactly what they did. We had some pretty good action straight away from the police. So we had a caravan deployed so that we can see the police visibly. That's not just our community, of course. There's lots of other communities that have been affected by the cyclone and are in the same spot as us. We're just kind of speaking on behalf of everybody because of that. So we're feeling a lot better because we've seen the police. They've been out there, they're visible. I spoke with police yesterday. The crime has gone down to pre-cyclone apparently, and I believe that just proves that having that visibility out there has worked. Should have been there right from day one.
Yeah, because that's what you were asking for was, you know, everyone was saying, oh, well, it's all about more resources and more troops, but you just wanted to be able to see where those police were. They weren't as visible as they are now. And you say that's made a difference to the crime rate. Have you been in contact with police, you know, all this whole time? And is there sort of steps that have happened along the way, or have you sort of just left it to this current situation? You're sort of going in 3 week chunks.
Well, when we had the first meeting, we said we're going to have a follow-up. And, I mean, the police have been amazing. They can only do as much as they are allowed to do. And, you know, that's what we're asking for, is give them more resources. The horse is kind of bolted now for us. You know, what we need and what we want and what we're going to keep demanding is when there is a disaster of this nature, get the army deployed. Have crime as number two on the priority list. Obviously, number one has to be rescue, but crime has to be number two, because when you're sitting in a really vulnerable spot, you don't want, I mean, I like to call them bottom feeders, coming into your community and taking stuff and scaring people. It's just not what you need at that time. So we need to make sure that moving forward, there is actually something, and this is why the political parties have been invited. We don't know who's going to be in power in October, so I want to make sure that everybody has a plan for this come October, that when an event like this happens again. I mean, we had the Christchurch earthquake and army were deployed. Why wasn't that given to us?
Louise, politics aside, when we spoke to police, they came back and said there just isn't the level of crime that these community groups are saying that there is. There isn't the guns being held in mass amounts in storage. The ammo isn't being sold out. Was there a bit of a disparity in the rhetoric that we were hearing from groups, or was it just a miscommunication? How do we reconcile the two different versions that police told us different things?
Well, I don't think you can put politics aside then, because I think that statement's political. And I don't think, I mean, we're feeling it. We're right here, you know, and the police have been right here with us now. But the police are here because we demanded it. There was definitely crime. We know that the police, that there were guns, and the police minister, Andrew Costa, he admitted that there was, you know, so there's been a lot of miscommunication, but not from us. Not from us.
We have a new police minister now, and I know that former Police Minister Stuart Nash was obviously a vocal voice, being a local member of your community as well. Have you had any communications with Ginny Anderson? Do you feel confident in her ability to serve your community's needs?
Well, you've got to give a person a chance. I haven't talked to her. I have invited her to the meeting, and I think if she turns up, then I'll have a lot more confidence. She needs be there, because we're not going away, and neither is crime. You know, the recovery's only just started. The Taupo Road's just opened for us, so it's going to open a whole new bunch of rooms, because now there's accessibility into the more remote areas. So I would like to be assured that that Ginny Anderson will come to our meeting on Sunday. She's been invited. Stuart Nash is coming, because of course he is the Napier MP. It's just a shame that there's no continuity, and what we need is continuity. He was at the first meeting, he listened, he made loads of notes, we've seen action. So we want to make sure that we get the second meeting is for feedback. So someone's got to give us feedback from the government, and if they try and sidetrack us because Stuart Nash is no longer the police minister, then I'll be really upset. But if Ginny can come just to see what we're talking about, meet us, just start rhetoric with us, you know, communication, so that she can get involved and help us.
Okay, we do have the police minister on later, so just quickly to confirm, she hasn't said whether she's going to come on Sunday or not.
No, I haven't had confirmation yet, but they are considering it. Yeah.
Oh,
so
okay.
I'd love to know if she's coming.
So would we. Thank you very much for your time. Louise Parsons, community member from the Esk Valley.
Thank you.
Will you be going to the meeting that the residents there are having on Sunday?
Well, first of all, I acknowledge it's been an incredibly tough time for residents in that area, and that is why we've had an extra police response on the ground. From my information, the meeting is a political meeting. They've asked all parties to come and present their political policies on law and order, and therefore I don't think it's appropriate I attend as Minister for Police, but Stuart Nash, as the local MP, will be there.
Okay. Stuart Nash attended as the police minister last time, and so did the police assistant commissioner, I think it was, or someone who was responsible in that region. The local commander attended the last meeting. So does that not imply that you should also attend a meeting like this?
I think it's important to distinguish that, again, there's been another meeting held where all political parties have been invited to present their policies for the upcoming election. I think that's slightly different to reassuring the community of the presence and place for police. The overall context is that we have not seen a spike in crime over that time, but police have put a good response on the ground. There's a dedicated 105 telephone line, there's pop-up mobile units that police have deployed, and police are, in addition to that, are also holding regional meetings across there for community to get information.
I just want to clarify something there, because there was actually quite a lot of discussion about this at the time, and you say there wasn't a spike in crime, but there was a lot of acknowledgement that there could have been some massive gaps in information and reporting there, because there was no power and no landlines for a while, and a lot of people felt frustrated but that they were being asked to simply file a report online, and that wasn't possible in the circumstances. So do you acknowledge that there may not be an accurate picture of the exact amount of crime that was occurring at the time? They're now telling us that they have been told by local police that the crime rate has gone down.
The information I've received from police recently is that there has not been a spike in crime. It's always really difficult at a tough time when community has been traumatised by a natural disaster. The police response has been to put an additional 145 officers on the ground, as well as mobile units. I'm satisfied that that response adequately meets the demands of the community and also reassures them of their safety. It's important that police are there to respond to criminal activity, but it's just important that they're there to reassure the community.
Have you had a briefing from the former police minister Stuart Nash about the situation on the East Coast?
No, I haven't had the opportunity to meet with Stuart yet. The House has been in recess, but I intend to do that very shortly.
Okay, just quickly, just only because you mentioned it just then, you know the number of extra police that are on the East Coast, but you're not aware of how many extra police might be brought into Auckland or Wellington this weekend for those counter protests?
I haven't been given that number. I've been given that number for the East Coast. I have not been provided that number for the protests. It may be something I'd need to check with police that's being assessed on a regular basis to look at what those risks and threats may be.
What is your expectation around the way that police will behave this weekend when dealing with both sides of these events?
The police values are to uphold those important things of being respectful and also to work with the community to uphold law and order. That is my expectation of New Zealand police, and they do that in situations where they're brought under pressure.
New Police Minister Ginny Anderson, thank you very much for your time this morning.
Thank you.